think something like that. That isn't a fun thing to think.
Okay, so I'm recording now, and that's so good to get at the beginning of the tape. You know, here's my dear friend Jerry, who's saying, why do you want to think something like that? That's not something to think. See, my mind. My mind still takes me out. So I was just sharing with Jerry, and I'm so excited that he's agreed to be interviewed about my Dare to Live challenge with the kids. And I was telling him how we met at CEO Space how many years ago?
Two years ago?
Oh, wow. And that's when I stopped coming, was exactly 2 years ago. Wow. And so I was just sharing with him how, you know, my whole journey and what brought me here. And I'm getting ready because I want everybody to hear this, but the last city that I left was Dallas, Texas, where I stopped to see my cousin, and people were like betting, how far will I get with this $100? And, you know, people have been so nice to contribute money, and as I'm coming closer, we decide to go to the Grand Canyon, and I get there, and I literally have like $30 left, and I find out the Grand Canyon's $25 to get in, and I'm going, okay, I'm going to live this dream. I'm going to do it to the fullest. This is what, you know, I wanted to do with the kids. And we end up going. And as we're driving up here, I'm like, I only have money to get to CEO Space. I don't even know where I'm going to stay. I don't know how I'm going to eat. You know, money that's coming in from some of the PayPal, it didn't make it to the bank account, and it's not coming until next week. And you know, coming here, you know, you've got food, you've got hotel, all this stuff. So as I'm driving up, I end up talking to one of my friends, and my friend said, if you need a place to stay, I'll give you my credit card and I'll sponsor it. So that took this huge load off. I mean, he literally paid for, you know, four nights of rooms.
Wow.
Then I get here and I'm thinking, how am I going to eat, right? What am I going to do for food? We're doing the SNAP today, and Michaela, my daughter, is doing the SNAP, and Alex raised $88 for his bass guitar. Michaela didn't raise any money, but she comes back and she goes, Mommy, this guy said that if I help him during lunch, he will, he'll pay me. So we go up there, and guess what he's doing? He's serving food to everybody, and he said that if the kids and everybody, if we help all the way till Monday night, we get to eat. So I'm just like, I mean, as crazy as it sounds, I'm just like, what the heck? So I get here, and I've seen Jerry, and Jerry, he's not wearing his hat. Wait, he's got this really cool hat. And I started talking to Jerry, and Jerry's sharing, you've got to tell people, because you are, I'm hoping that this is one of many interviews, you are really, really daring to live. I mean, I am just blown away. I've never met anybody that's taking the risks that you're taking with your dream. So first, will you just share a little bit about what is your dream and your project that you're working on?
The 2010 Recovery Is Now Tour, in which we're motivating people to take action right now. The time to recover, honestly, for everyone, is now. It's not time to complain about things outside of our control anymore. It's time. We're never going to build a fortress or a castle without a proper foundation. So complaining about things out of our control, like what's going on in the federal government, these sort of situations, all this stuff is out of our control. A lot of people are busy complaining and worrying about what's going on in Washington or whatever outside of our immediate community. So we complain and then we get stuck into fear and stress and all these things that keep us paralyzed from taking action. Without any action, nothing ever changes. We can be the country that just explodes and pulls our heads up out of this global economic recession that's going on. We step up as a nation, this wonderful nation we are, and then by our leading, the rest of the planet will step up as well. But we can't do it without taking action right now. It's the Recovery Is Now tour, and it's not just personal recoveries, but global recovery as well. It needs to take place. It's time right now. That's what it's about.
So when you say recovery, what does that mean to people that may not, you know, what's your interpretation of recovery?
The definition of the word recovery is to continue living as if nothing ever happened. That's it. So like, okay, well, I had a severe traumatic brain injury when I was 15 years old. I've recovered 100%. There's no limitation by the brain injury anymore. I'm living as if this severe debilitating accident never happened. It's a full recovery from a permanent disability. There's That's with everything. It doesn't matter what we talk about. We can talk about paralysis, we can talk about stress, we can talk about relationships. Recovery is moving forward as if nothing ever happened.
Wow. Like totally living in the moment. So tell them a little bit about this tour that you're doing. I mean, it is just fascinating. You've traveled 2,700 miles on a bike.
So far.
There's the yet. Okay.
Wow. Yeah, it's fun.
Look at him glow. Look at him.
Okay, so I want to tell you about the tour before I tell you about it.
Okay, and I'm gonna go like this when we have 1 minute left, okay? Because it's a 10 minute thing.
1 minute?
No, you have plenty. You have like 4 minutes.
Okay, so I wanted to do this in a big way, and well, okay, so I went on a 47-mile ride, and it was a lot of fun. And I like to do things over the top, so I figured, okay, well, what I'm gonna do is go around the nation. So I talked to my friend, and she said, why don't you do it to benefit your nonprofit? It's like, wow, that's a great idea. So I wrote up this rough idea, and I presented it to the board of directors, and they said, great, go for it. So I'm doing this to motivate people to take action, but the last thing I wanted to hear anyone say was, Jerry did this great feat, but he did it because he's got money, or because he's got connections, or because he's got businesses, or because he's got fill in the blank. I didn't want to have people to have those excuses, because we all have excuses, and the excuses prevent us from taking action. Without taking action, nothing ever changes. Therefore, it defeats all recovery, and it's all about recovery. So I started off on my mountain bike from sixth grade. I put $200 into the bike. That was it. And I started pedaling from Logan, Utah. Okay, up toward Vancouver, BC. Wasn't gonna pay for lodging or food the whole way through. Had no clue how the food thing was gonna work. I was gonna use couchsurfing.org to get my lodging, where people offer rooms and things like this. Day before I started, a guy I met said, well, what if you have a tire blowout or something? If you're going alone, what ifs. Yeah. And I said, well, I've never had a tire blowout in my entire life, so maybe, I don't know, it'll work out. Something will happen. Well, day one starts, and I'm pedaling along, you know, having a good time. I'm on a dirt road in the middle of nowhere in Utah. I come up over this hill, and there's a group of people training their dogs to be sheep herders. So I'm pedaling past them, and you're pop. My rear tire blew out. The sidewall blew out. Well, I was right there by these people, so they helped me get it fixed, and I was able to ride forward. But I was right there. That's what happens.
Synchronicity, yeah.
Exactly. So that was on day one. A little bit further, I pushed my bike through 5 feet of snow in Oregon. Yeah, that was fun. It's been amazing, all the opportunities that have taken place. When I started it, I didn't have any affiliation except for Best Buy. Best Buy donated a computer, so like a blog. Day two, Walmart said they would start sponsoring. So day two, I started getting Walmart sponsorships along the way for more food and things. So that was exciting. And I've just been going forward. I've ridden 2,700 miles so far, I believe, between 26 and 2,700 miles. And from New York City to LA is 2,750 miles. I've ridden from Logan, Utah to Vancouver and down to Long Beach. That is right near 2,700 miles. That's how far I've ridden so far.
Whoa.
And then the tour goes from here over to Maine, and then across the country to Maine, then over to Australia, around Australia for 4 months, back to Maine, down to Key West, and then back to San Diego. It's the world's longest tour to benefit a nonprofit organization. The current world record is 4,000 miles. This tour is 16,500 miles.
Whoa. And you had a woman, you were saying, that had quit her job.
Yeah, she quit two jobs to join me for half of the California part. So I think it'd be a lot like the Forrest Gump story. People are going to join as the tour progresses.
Great. And how can they follow you on your blog? Tell them what...
Go to 2010rint.org. That's 2010 Recovery is Down Tour, R-I-N-T. Or go to BrainGuyJerry.com.
BrainGuyJerry.com. I'm going to interview again while we're here in the next couple days, I'm hoping.
Okay.
All right. Maybe. Thank you for daring to live. What were you going to say? Maybe what?
Maybe even when I'm in Florida next year.
Yes.
A little further on down the road.
All right. Oh, you rock. Thanks so much.
Life's like a road that you travel on. One day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world.